That may be the greatest catch I've ever seen in my life.
All right, guys, I am very excited to be back. I'm very excited to start making y'all normal videos yet again every single day. And yeah, I mean, the channel has continued to grow at an incredible rate. Never thought we would be this far this early on a fantasy basketball channel. If I knew y'all were looking for fantasy basketball content so badly, I would have made this a while ago. But regardless, I'm going to continue to make a video for y'all every day. Thank y'all so much for dropping those likes, leaving those comments, and subscribing to the channel. And I'll say on this video, guys, please go down to that comment section, ask any questions that you have regarding your fantasy basketball team, as that question could be used later on in one of our question and answer videos. But in this video, what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be going through the top 10 current guards in Yahoo overall scoring. So obviously, this list is going to be impacted by some players playing more than others. I mean, players like James Harden, who have not been able to put in a significant amount of games, are not going to be at the top just because their overall counting stats are not there. So this is not a rankings list. I just think it would be a decent idea to make this video every few weeks so we can keep a track of how players are trending and where we are going towards. Okay, well, let's start it off with our first guard, which has been on a tear to start the season, and this is going to be Bradley Beal. Okay, so Bradley Beal currently in Yahoo scoring is the number one guard after playing 10 games. Not only was he able to go out there and get that high total of games played, but he's been able to bring incredible per game statistics because obviously he's at number one right now. I mean, averaging 35 points a game at the time of this recording, averaging close to 50% from the field, 5 rebounds, almost 5 assists. Bradley Beal is really not lacking in any one category. I'll say this, I mean, with the overall Washington Wizards team, it's just so interesting on what they are going to do with Bradley Beal as the season progresses, because it clearly does not matter the type of talent that Beal has. This team is not going to be a contender regardless. Does Bradley Beal want to continue to play for a franchise that has no shot at winning, even when he's going out there and dropping 50 points in a game? They are still losing those. I mean, the defense on this team is horrendous, and they're just not able to stop anyone. I will say, for Bradley Beal's fantasy value, it kind of goes without saying that we want him in Washington because this team is going to be seeing so many possessions per game with their transition defense not being where you would want it to be. This is going to cause just the pace of play for whatever team is playing them going to be a little bit higher than their usual average. So we are going to see a ton of possessions. Bradley Beal has an incredible usage rate even when Russell Westbrook is playing for this Washington franchise. So yeah, I mean, Bradley Beal on a tear right now. If you own him, you have been so happy. You just want him to stay in Washington. Okay, so now our next player has also played 10 games, so he's going to be ahead of some other guys averaging better per game statistics. But this is going to be Jaylen Brown. Okay, right now with Jaylen Brown, it looks like he is taking that next leap. I mean, we saw a small leap for him in the bubble, but now, I mean, he has just gone right past that. In 10 games, he has been able to average over 26 points. Not only is he averaging 26 points, but he is doing so with great efficiency, almost 55% from the field and over 40% from three. Now, with the three-point percentage, it's going to be intriguing to see how that continues. We don't necessarily want to say that he is not a fantastic three-point shooter, but is he going to be able to maintain that efficiency with the volume of shots that he is putting up? The one problem here is he is not giving you elite-level assist, only averaging 3.5, but over 6 rebounds. And when you're getting this type of efficiency and scoring, I mean, that is something that you are really 100% willing to take on the profile if you're going to be able to stuff the stat sheet of those other categories. Okay, so now our next player that we are going to talk about has only played 9 games. His per game statistics are a lot better than Jaylen Brown's, but this is going to be Steph Curry. Okay, Steph Curry started slow, but since then, I mean, he has looked incredible. In 9 games, he is averaging over 30 points. He is doing so with 45% of those shots coming in from the field. And we know that he is unreal from three-point land. This goes without saying with Steph Curry. He's already made 40 threes in 9 games. His assist numbers aren't necessarily where you would expect them to be in terms of just elite usage rate in his rotation. I mean, 6.5 assists, I would expect that number to be a little bit higher, but it's not something that we are going to be too scared of. And almost a steal and a half per game. I mean, Steph Curry is exactly what you drafted him for. Okay, so now let's talk about a player that is way more than what you drafted him for. Played in 11 games, so definitely at the top of this list because of those raw total numbers. Would be a little bit lower if we were looking at per game numbers. But this is going to be Zach LaVine. Now with Zach LaVine, I mean, it's been scoring, scoring, scoring. In 11 games, he's averaging almost 28 points per game. Just straight up ridiculous, especially with his overall efficiency from the field, shooting 49%. And with his threes, the efficiency is not necessarily there, 37%, so nothing that you need to be too worried about. But what we love to see is he is shooting that three ball over and over and over again. I mean, the volume for with his three-point attempts is absolutely ridiculous. So the three-pointers are going to be there if you're playing in a category league. And if we look at rebounds, we look at assists, he's averaging 5 rebounds, 4.5 assists. Not too bad at all, considering the scoring he's giving you, and also almost a steal and a half per game. Okay, so now coming in here at our 5 spot, definitely would be way higher than this if we were looking at per game numbers, but this is going to be Luka. Okay, so Luka has only played 8 games so far this season. We know that he has started extremely slow, but he has gone on a full-on tear as of late. In those 8 games, he's averaged almost 27 points per game, which obviously not jumping off the page compared to other players like Bradley Beal. His efficiency isn't there either. I mean, 45% from the field, but what is honestly exciting, in my opinion, with Luka is yes, he has had decent performances in points and his overall percentage from the field, but his threes have been horrendous. I mean, he is averaging 22% from beyond the arc, and we know this is something that's just a small sample size thing. I mean, once we get Luka putting up more shots, once we just get more numbers in that data set, that percentage should go closer to his career average. So if he's already averaging close to 27 points per game, if a couple of those three-point shots start to fall, I mean, that number could easily jump up over 30. And the rebounds and the assists are elite for what you would expect from him. 9 rebounds and 8 assists per game. I mean, Luka is someone that could easily average a triple-double down the stretch. I mean, he is so close to being there as is. And if he continues to trend the way he is now, I think he'll get there. Okay, so now let's go over and let's talk about a player that I have to admit I was wrong on. I did not like him in fantasy basketball drafts this past offseason. But CJ McCollum, I mean, coming out here at our number 6 spot, in 9 games, he's been averaging 28 points, 47% from the field, and he has been giving you so much value in that 3-point category. Rebounds, assists, nothing jumping off the page, 4 rebounds, 5 assists a game, but 2 steals a game. We know how valuable that is, not only in point leagues, but specifically category leagues where CJ McCollum is almost carrying your team on his back to take that category from your opponent. I mean, CJ McCollum, just someone I'm just going to have to take the L on. And now our next player is going to be someone that I'm expecting to fall as the season progresses, but this is going to be Malcolm Brogdon. Okay, so here with Brogdon, he's played 9 games, and his numbers in terms of his points, rebounds, assists, solid, nothing fantastic. I mean, 23 points a game, 4 rebounds a game, 7 assists as well. But why I'm expecting him to take a step back is, one, he's averaging close to 2 steals a game, something that I'm not going to be able to expect to maintain as the course of the season progresses, and also his 3-point efficiency. I mean, he is shooting almost 50% from beyond the arc, and while we're expecting Luka to be a player that's going to take a step forward in that category, I think here with Brogdon, he takes a step backwards. All right, so now our next player, another player that I was not advocating for you to draft in your fantasy basketball leagues in his range. It's going to be Damian Lillard. Okay, so here Damian Lillard's coming in at 8 with 9 games played, 26 points a game. Honestly, the efficiency has not been close to what you'd want to see. 43% from the field. He's giving you unreal value in the three-point category. 4.5 rebounds, 6.5 assists, and almost a steal a game. I mean, if you took Lillard at the end of the first, beginning of the second, I mean, you were expecting a little bit more. And now another player I did not like, another player I may have to take an L on, it's going to be DeMar DeRozan coming in here at 9 with 9 games played, averaging 21 points a game, 49% from the field. As always, he's giving you really no value in terms of these other guards from the three-point category. 5.5 rebounds, 7 assists, and decent defensive numbers. I mean, DeMar DeRozan looks like a value in fantasy drafts right now. And now our next player, definitely way more valuable in category leagues so far, is going to be Trae Young. So Trae Young started off so hot, but since then he's cooled off a little. And in 9 games, he's averaging 25 points, 40% from the field, and where he is just completely missing the ball is his three-point percentage. With Trae Young, we know he's one of the best three-point shooters in the entire NBA, so I'm going to be expecting Trae Young to be a massive riser over the next month once some more of those shots start falling. But we also know the value that he gives you from the free throw line, so Trae Young definitely much more valuable in a category league rather than a straight-up points league. All right, now, thank you guys. I really hope y'all enjoyed this video. I really hope y'all got something from it. As always, if y'all did, go down there, drop that like, leave that comment, subscribe to the channel. It really, really helps us out. And yeah, that's it. I'll see y'all with the video tomorrow.